We apologize for any technical difficulties we may have had starting the broadcast. I'm David Clark, and
I'm Sydney DeGrazia,
and we'll have your coverage of this contest.
The Bulldogs and the Villanova Wildcats are 1-1 in Big East play so far, so this will decide between the two. Butler lost a close one against DePaul on Thursday, and Villanova lost against number 11 Georgetown.
Yeah, indeed. Butler had a little bit of issue on offense in that game against DePaul. They put up only 6 shots, 2 were on goal, and there was no scoring by either side in the second half. So they're going to try and right that today if they have any hope of coming out with a win against Villanova. Ball passed along the sideline to number 2, Katie Soderstrom. And that's out of bounds. Julie Leonard, number 6, will take the throw in from the near side. Can't win that ball, and Villanova will take over on their half of the field. Clears it now. A couple of headers by Butler, and Soderstrom gets the ball back. Looking to push it forward. No one in front of her. She's making her run toward the post. Can't hold it, though, and that'll be a goal kick for Villanova. Keeper for Villanova today is Rebecca Gartner. She's a redshirt senior from Danbury, Connecticut. She's also a transfer from Baylor. With the left-footed kick. And Villanova collects it back now. Butler putting some pressure on Villanova in there. Ooh. Deflected out, but that'll be another goal kick for the Wildcats. Butler maintaining possession on their half of midfield. They switch their area of possession now as they come back across the field. That's number 8, Morgan Klusterman. As Villanova tries to clear it away, they do so there. Jane Olcott dribbling with the ball now. And Butler gets it back. If you're just joining us, it's tied at 0 in the 12th minute of action here. No score. Connor Huggins fights for it on the sideline. Tries to keep it and pass it ahead to Olcott. But Butler maintains possession now.
Butler seems to take the ball down the field more with a passing rate as the Villanova Wildcats are running it more down the field.
Yeah, Butler opting for more passes on the ground than headers. A good run here by Anya Savage. Oh, it's a late offsides call. But good offensive energy from the Bulldogs coming out of the gate. That's what you like to see. Leonard collects it now. Pushes it back. As Schmidt takes it. Now Julia Leonard with it. Pass on to Morgan Klusterman. She's looking for teammates. Gets it down to Soderstrom on the edge, looking for a cross in, and that's deflected out. The Bulldogs will have a corner kick here in the 13th minute of play.
This is something they really need to capitalize on. In that game against DePaul, they just couldn't seem to get the ball in after corner kicks and free kick opportunities.
On the season, Butler is plus 24 in corner kicks over their opponents, but they've struggled more in the first half. A good attempted flick. Looks like that was Annika Schmidt in there, but couldn't direct it on goal. It'll be another corner kick for the Bulldogs. You can't highlight enough, putting offensive pressure on the opposition early in the game, it can really wear them down after a while, and it looks like that's what the Bulldogs are attempting to do here. Soderstrom will take the kick again. Arm is up, approaches the ball. It's outside the box, just barely. Ooh, but a good shot, deflected out by Rebecca Gartner, the Villanova goalie. And just like that, Butler will have its third corner kick in a row.
Yeah, third corner kick in a row. That's really going to help this Butler offense out to tire those Villanova Wildcats.
Approach. Cross in. There was a deflection in there, but it was off a Bulldog. Again, good, consistent offensive pressure by the goalie box. Butler, unfortunately, comes up empty. But as we mentioned, three corner kicks in a row. That's something you like to see at the start. And Gartner will take the kick for Villanova. It's out on number 20, Allison Breed for the Wildcats. Bulldogs will get a throw in from the far side of the field. And she moves about 5 feet forward. Another throw in here. Maintains possession by Savage. Across the field to Schmidt. Soderstrom now. Looking for Leonard. Can't find her, but Butler keeps it in. Back to Soderstrom again. Good passing here by the Bulldogs. Soderstrom looking to cross. Ooh. Blocked by the goalie. She punched it out of there. Can't find the opposite side run, Villanova, so Butler will take it back over. It's Schmidt. To Leonard, and they'll play it back to Rodriguez. Stephanie Rodriguez has 4 shutouts for the Bulldogs so far this season. Most recent one coming a week ago when the Bulldogs played Seton Hall and won by a score of 3-0. Their opening game in Big East play and their first win. Schmidt plays it ahead. Tries to find Macy Miller. Macy Miller again. And the call is a Butler throw-in.
Butler has seemed to maintain majority of the possession thus far in this half, which is a nice thing to see.
strictly from a matchup point, Sydney, why is Butler excited to play this game against Villanova? What kind of advantage do you see them having in this game?
Yeah, you know, they're both 1-1 on Big East play, but I think Butler is really trying to rebound from that 2-1 loss at DePaul. It wasn't really a normal thing for that team. They just didn't start off well, and they have a standout sophomore class, and I think that's something really special about this team to take on against this Villanova Wildcat team.
Now, you mentioned sophomore standouts. Obviously, Anya Savage is at the head of that list. She leads the team in shots and goals. Want to see her get involved today if you can.
Yeah, just in the starting lineup alone, Butler has 4 sophomores starting.
Something you don't routinely see from maybe other highly ranked universities. Butler wins it back on defense as Klusterman will play it out to her right to Leonard, to Alyssa Yarish, as Yarish looks up the field. Just playing keep away right now. You got to win the possession game. And Klusterman will play it back to Rodriguez.
Another thing from the match point of view, Butler is very good at getting those corner kick and free kick opportunities, as we've already seen here with those 3 in a row. So if they're able to capitalize on those, it should be good for them today.
Yes, Butler on the season, they have a record of 6-4-1. Ooh, as a mistake here, tries to get it past the goalkeeper, tries to play it over her head, but it's off target. A good thought there, trying to take advantage of a mistaken positioning, nearly gets the goal there. But for the season, Butler does lead its opponents in a lot of offensive categories. They lead in goals, they have a plus 10 differential. They have taken 60 more shots than their opponents, which, again, very good from an offensive standpoint. And they haven't forced their goalie to make a lot of difficult saves, only 34 on the year. That's a plus 20, or plus... yeah, plus 26 differential there. On the far side, Schmidt takes it. As Taylor Crow puts the throw in into play. And a reverse of field now. Leonard will take the ball up. That's Klusterman. Alyssa Yarish, but they can't find Leonard, who's moving toward the goal box. It's a Butler team who has 8 Bulldogs from the state of Indiana, 4 from Ohio, 4 from Michigan, and 3 from Illinois. So a lot of talent very close to home for the Bulldogs.
You'll see this Butler team also play back, play to the goalie, play in this defensive side to maintain that possession and kind of just reassess and calm down the team.
Deflection there from Villanova, but Butler wins that. Soderstrom plays it on the far side to Celia Gaynor. Can't find her there. That was Macy Miller, rather. Villanova plays it out, but Butler will have another chance to throw in. Macy Miller takes it. Yarish. Schmidt will take it back on Butler's side of midfield. No foul there. A little bit of contact as Gaynor plays it out, and the Wildcats will take a throw in. We're tied at zero in the with 27 minutes remaining until halftime. Butler's primarily been winning the possession battle here, keeping the ball on Villanova's side of midfield. The Bulldogs do have one tie on the year. That came at the hands of Utah. It was a road game there. Two overtimes and there was no score. So Butler definitely wants to try and get some offensive rhythm going. You don't want to wait too long to start making your runs toward the goal. Butler applying pressure now. Villanova making a run. That's Bryce McEnroy with the ball now, evading Butler defenders. Ooh. Nice play there by Macy Miller. And Taylor Crow with it now. It's the first sustained offensive pressure we've seen from Villanova for any period of time here. Sure, if you're Villanova's coaches, you want to see more of that. Coming into the season, Butler was ranked number 2 in a Big East preseason poll. As that's an offsides call there.
Butler has a very successful home record as well. Over even the past few years, they rarely lose at home. So they're very excited to start off their Big East homestand today.
Yeah, Butler was very successful last year as well as Schmidt plays it forward to Soderstrom. It goes out on the sideline, can't exactly find her. But Butler was very successful in their season last year as well with a final record of 13-6-1. They finished 6-2-1 in the Big East. That was second place. And there are 7 newcomers on this team for the Bulldogs this year. So a good turnover in talent.
They have a very young team with those 7 newcomers and then those sophomore standouts we talked about earlier.
Peyton Black with a touch now. Tries to get it to Crow over on the side. She stops it before it rolls out. Plays it forward to Macy Miller. Making a run toward the goal. And that's stopped by Gartner. Gartner tries to play it ahead. Oh, the pass picked off by number 9 for Villanova, Bryce McEnroy. But Butler defends it well. Taylor Crow now. She'll give it to Celia Gaynor. As Butler content to play it on their own side of the field. 24 minutes until halftime. Still no score if you're just joining us. This is Butler's third Big East contest. So far they're 1-1 as Gaynor steals it. Now a run by Miller. Faking out the defender. No foul call. As Butler plays it out of bounds, and that's a goal kick.
Still have been no fouls this game, and Villanova doesn't have any shots on goal.
And Villanova will get a sub in Villanova now. Out is number 20, Allison Breed. And in is number 10, Chloe O'Neill for the Wildcats. She's a sophomore forward from Plantation, Florida. Garish plays it across the field to Leonard now. Leonard back to Schmidt. Schmidt keeps looking for Soderstrom on her right, streaking down the sideline. She's connected with her a couple times so far in this game. And then on the other side, you have Macy Miller, who's made a couple of nice runs. Gaynor now with it. Crow tries to play it back toward midfield. Villanova has it for a second, but Schmidt collects it now and plays it back to Rodriguez. Schmidt going forward, finds Gaynor. Savage tries to play it ahead to Miller. Villanova collects it now. Butler applying good pressure in their defensive zone. As Wildcats really haven't been able to get a whole lot downfield. We haven't seen a shot from Villanova yet. We've seen a couple by Butler. Tries to play it ahead, and that'll be far enough for Rodriguez to take it. Rodriguez throws it out on the side to an instep Leonard. Leonard looking for Soderstrom again to her right. Doesn't find her. Instead opts to go back to the center toward Peyton Black. Peyton Black now takes it to Crow. Deflected out. Crow will take it on the throw in. Gaynor. Back to Schmidt across midfield. Now they find Soderstrom on the far side, but it goes out of bounds before they can make contact with the pass.
The Dogs have been much more successful getting the ball on Villanova's side. It's just the struggle to finish that ball through the goal.
Olcott tries to take the throw in from Villanova, but Butler wins it back yet again. Oh, this could be trouble here, number nine. Bryce McEnroy tries to find someone in the offensive zone. That's Chloe O'Neill, who just came into the game. She gets a touch, puts it forward enough for McEnroy. And Butler plays it out. So now they'll play defense for the first time off a throw-in deep in their own defensive zone. And O'Neill will have the throw-in.
Villanova hasn't had a corner kick yet either, so they're definitely looking for some opportunity down here on Butler's side of the field.
Barber plays it to Connor Huggins. And that's a Butler throw-in. So defensed very nicely. Didn't let them into any closer to the goal. Schmidt being badgered now by McEnroy. Finding Savage on the run. Waiting for her team to catch up. Tries a cross. That's Macy Miller. She tries to collect it. She can't get the touch. Instead, Villanova ahead. Number seven, Sam Rosette. And with that, that's the first foul committed in the game. And Butler will have it on a throw-in. No score. 18 and a half minutes left before halftime here at the Selleck Bowl. And Leonard will take the throw
Villanova
in.
Villanova substitution 16, Nikki Molina for 7, Sam Rosette.
Nikki Molina, number 16, will now come in for number 7, Sam Rosette.
Villanova's trying to get some fresh legs in here to see if they can make some changes and get some opportunities.
Ooh. Savage with it. She's fouled.
This is a nice free kick opportunity for the Bulldogs down on Villanova's side of the field.
You can definitely put some more pressure on the goal now. Just outside the 25-yard line.
Yeah, you'll see every person from this Bulldog team has pushed up except for one lone defender back here.
Amanda Kowalski now in the game. She puts it toward the back line. Goalie punches it away. Still in play if Schmidt can get it. And Schmidt has to deflect it out. Good scoring opportunity there. 17 minutes until halftime. Butler has 2 shots on the game. Villanova does not have a shot recorded yet. Connor Huggins on the near side of the field now. Back to Kristen Barber. Toward the middle, Daniela Nelson trying to dribble it around Klusterman. And Macy Miller picks it off now. Tries to get it back toward Gaynor. The shot's a little short. Nikki Molina makes the run now. She's just in the game. Goes back to her left, looking for space. Across the middle, Chloe O'Neill, who came in. And that's a shot, but it's above the goal. Good movement on the ground for Villanova, but Butler forced them to take a shot from a little farther away than they would have liked. First good quality defensive possession from the Bulldogs. A little over 15 minutes until halftime. Butler wins the header. They lose it now to Villanova, who plays it forward. And they'll opt to play it back to... No, they could have played it to Rodriguez. Instead, they throw it out. And Villanova will have another substitute. Out is number 13, Daniela Nelson. And in is Grace Karajosi, a freshman from Rumson, New Jersey. The throw in goes to Chloe O'Neill now, who takes a shot high above the goal. Not really a good option there. And Rodriguez will take it.
It seems like Villanova has just been taking the shots as soon as they see them, and it's been going over the goal most times.
It's a good defensive struggle thus far. As Miller fights for it, but Villanova will play it back. Misses on the pass ahead. Now Julia Leonard collects the ball. And Amanda Kowalski in the game. Olcott tries to put it in her possession, but she's fouled. Kick taken quickly by Villanova, trying to play it in. Butler defending very tightly over there on number 16, Nikki Molina. And it goes off Molina. We have no score here at the Selick Bowl in Butler's third Big East contest of the season. First home contest in the Big East. 13 and a half minutes before halftime.
It seems in the last 5-10 minutes, Villanova has actually taken more of the possession of the ball.
And you figure at some point they would. Butler really dictated everything going on in the game for the first 20 minutes or so. Good run by Miller here. Good speed. Looking across to Savage. Can't make it through the wall of two Villanova defenders. And Kowalski gets beat on the sideline now. Tries to catch up. Plays it ahead to McEnroy. If she can stop it before it gets out, she can't. Good thought by Villanova. Just can't execute it exactly like they want. And a substitution for Butler now. Macy Miller is out. Brief respite.
Bulldog substitution, 16, Gretchen Skoglund.
And in will come in Gretchen Skoglund, a 5'8 freshman from St. Louis, Missouri. It goes back to the point you were mentioning earlier, Sydney. The Bulldogs have a lot of youth on this team, and they can really rely on that when they need it, especially when they're giving some of their better players a short break.
Definitely.
Leonard wins it now, keeps it in. That's Gaynor. Tries to run, trips over the ball. Savage fighting for it, and Savage is going to be called for a foul as she was trying to get the ball back. A little under 12 minutes until halftime here. Kristen Barber plays it ahead, looking for Olcott. Alyssa Yarich making sure no one touches it before it goes out. That's a goal kick. And Rodriguez has not had to face much pressure at all so far here.
41, Michaela Sadler for 9, Bryce McEnroy.
Bryce McEnroy will take a seat for the Wildcats. Gaynor takes it, plays it ahead to number 16, Skoglund. And that's played out into the visitors' bleachers. And as soon as they get the ball in, it's Peyton Black with it now. Plays it back to Annika Schmidt. Kowalski with it to Soderstrom, leader in assists on the team, looks for a cross in, nearly finds a streaking Skoglund. The goalie, Rebecca Gartner, punches it away. Connor Huggins now tries to play to Villanova, who's on the run. They don't have numbers, but they find Olcott in the middle, and Butler commits a foul.
Free kick opportunity for Villanova at about that 30-yard line is pretty good opportunity for them to try and capitalize on this.
With all the offensive pressure Butler's been putting on Villanova on the offensive end, you worry about them getting back on defense if Villanova can gain possession quickly like they did in that opportunity.
About 9 minutes to play until halftime, so everyone is definitely trying to capitalize on each opportunity.
Both teams looking for a score. The kick goes in, and they were trying to find Chloe O'Neill on the left side of the goalie box. It didn't quite make it to her, but Butler does play it out, and that's going to give the first corner for Villanova.
Villanova substitution
in this match so far.
33, Reagan Smith for 8, Jane Olcott.
Meanwhile, Reagan Smith comes in. Jane Olcott goes out. Someone with fresh legs to take the jump. They play it short from the corner. Villanova with it. Blocked, and Butler plays it out very nicely. Kristen Vinsegura tried to put the shot on goal, but didn't have enough time, and Butler plays it out. Vinsegura with it now. Back toward middle of the field. Backing down is number 21, Michaela Stadler. Came in as a sub a couple minutes ago. Connor Huggins now as Gaynor falls down. Ahead, tries to play to Chloe O'Neill, does number 33, Reagan Smith. But that's going to be a Butler throw-in. Under 8 minutes until halftime here. Can Butler get another good offensive shift before they go into halftime?
You definitely want to go into halftime feeling like you were the one controlling this game and having that momentum. Going into the second half is vital.
Soderstrom puts it on the ground, tries to play it to Klusterman. Barber plays it ahead for Villanova. Game's a little more physical now. Vince Agura takes it for Villanova. Out on the side to number 22, Kara Josie. Butler wins it back. Amanda Kowalski. Soderstrom trying to make a run. She's shown good speed in this game. Can she find someone on the cross? Oh! Anya Savich. Nearly with a nice flick on the cross from Soderstrom. Goalie punches it out. So this might be the offensive opportunity we were looking for. As there's been a little bit of a lull in the last 10, 15 minutes of play. Butler really pushing the envelope early on. Three corners in a row. And not much since. Soderstrom is going to take the corner again. It's a low line drive. Blocked out closer to midfield now. Klusterman. Soderstrom back on the left. Soderstrom looking for a cross again. Goalie nearly misses it. Goalie overcommitted to the left side and nearly missed a cross back toward the center that would have gone on goal. Kowalski looking for space. Kowalski tries to put it on the right post. It was deflected out, though.
Substitution for Butler.
So Butler will get one more substitution here with about 5 minutes left before halftime. Looks like Butler's only been held scoreless in one game so far this season. That was the tie against Utah. The cross in. Chloe O'Neill gets it, and Villanova plays it back out toward midfield. Kowalski. And it's a very big misplay by the Bulldogs. Rodriguez gets it, tries to get the second save, but can't. And like that, Butler is now behind 1-0.
In the 41st minute
of play, Butler gives up its first goal. Butler just couldn't collect it on the defensive side of the field. As the Villanova forwards ran past them.
All the attention was on that Butler offense just a minute ago, and almost every player was pushed up, so when Villanova got that opportunity on the other side of the field, they capitalized on it.
And that's what good teams can do against you. Good teams can turn defense right into an offensive shift and hurt you. Skoglund with it, manages to push it down the field rather quickly. And there's a corner kick now. That's going to be Butler's fifth in the game. Again, not much time until half. 4.5 minutes. Soderstrom, who's taken all the corners so far, will do so again. Her approach, the kick, still a line drive, a little low. Tries to find something inside, but Butler can't flick it on goal. And Gartner collects it.
Soderstrom has also taken a lot of those offensive leaps for the Butler team, and she had the only goal. against the DePaul team on Thursday.
Klusterman with it now. Plays out to Kowalski. Again, Butler trying to push and try to get an equalizer before halftime. The cross inside, nearly headed by Savage. Collected by Peyton Black now, midfielder. Played inside to number 23, Aaliyah Dean. And it's a change of possession back to Villanova with 3 minutes, 20 seconds left here. Villanova with four shots so far in the half. They lead 1-0. Butler with five shots, five corners, but no scoring to show for it yet.
They're able to create those offensive opportunities. They just haven't been able to finish them.
Barber plays it ahead now to Reagan Smith. And played out. It's a throw-in for Butler with 2.5 minutes before halftime now. Butler trying to collect it. Connor Huggins with it now. Villanova looking for more. They can't find anyone. Butler good, well defended there. Amanda Kowalski streaking on the near side of the field. Finds Soderstrom, who's playing more inside now, but the pass is behind the intended Skoglund, and Annika Schmidt will take it back now as Butler wins it back. Looking for Savage on the left side. Peyton Black with it now. Dean with it. Dean takes it all the way down, looking for someone toward the goal box again. Can't find anyone. Butler keeps it in. Nice fake there to keep play alive by Leonard. Skoglund trying to keep it. Klusterman to Kowalski. 1.5 minutes left before halftime. This is Butler's chance. Soderstrom on the right, like we've seen her all game, with the cross in. Nearly headed into the goal by Kristen Barber for the Wildcats, but it does go over the crossbar. It's Butler's sixth corner kick in the first half so far.
That's an extremely high number for a soccer game.
1 minute. One minute to play
before halftime. Could be one of the final opportunities so far in the half. Katie Soderstrom will take it again. Sophomore from Carmel, Indiana. Hits it. Goalie punches it out. Kowalski trying to collect it. Back to Klusterman. Gives it back to Kowalski. Doesn't exactly make it. And the offside flag goes up. Bulldogs have 20 seconds before halftime if they can make a final push. But again, we talk about in the deep offensive zone, going right back on defense. And they almost got beat down the field again. Less than 10 seconds before halftime. Can't find Savage. And with that, the first half of play has come to a close. It's a goal in the 41st minute by Villanova. And Butler trails at halftime 1-0. What did you see in the first half, Sydney?
Yeah, you know, I think we saw two powerhouse Big East teams going at it in this half. And possession was pretty split, but Butler just hasn't been able to finish on those offensive opportunities that they're creating for themselves. And Villanova took that opportunity they had when everyone was pushed up to create that goal. So I think in this next half, if Butler can finish those opportunities and maybe switch their tactics on corner kicks, then they have a good shot at competing for the win today.
All right, that's the first half of play here at the Selig Bowl. The Butler Bulldogs trail Villanova 1-0. We'll see you back after halftime.
Our score at halftime, Villanova 1, Butler 0. It's Soccer Sunday time. Our ice cream sundae bar will be open for kids throughout halftime at the top of Section 1.
I'm gonna go. can hear my father's laugh. In a happy home, I wish a pin I had grown strong. Those days are gone, now the memories on the wall. I hear the song from the places where I was born.
It's last call for Soccer Sunday Time. Stop by the top of Section 1 for kids to get a free ice cream sundae. Today's Big East Women's Soccer Contest is brought to you by Indy 11. Your opportunity for 2020 season tickets for your Indy 11 are available now by contacting the office at 317-685-1100 or at indy11.com. You won't want to miss the opportunity for 17 world-class soccer games, with the 2019 record-breaking year making the 2020 season one not to be missed.
Don't you worry, don't you worry now. Yeah.
Welcome back to the second half of play here at the Selleck Bowl, as Butler Women's Soccer is currently in the midst of a matchup with the Big East Villanova Wildcats. After one half of play, Butler trails 1-0 from a goal in the 42nd minute by Michaela Stadler for the Wildcats. Butler dominated possession for most of the first half, but they just couldn't find the opportunities to get ball in the back of the net. Once again, I'm joined by Sydney. We'll be covering the second half of action here. And Butler will get the second half kickoff.
The Bulldogs are really going to try and get a goal soon here, as a 1-0 game is very different from a 2-0. So to tie it up is vital to play today.
Looking at the first half, Butler ended up having 7 corner kicks, while Villanova only had 1. And Jane Olcott back in the game now, tries to push it ahead, but she's off target. In total, the Bulldogs had 5 shots in the first half. Villanova had 3. And then, obviously, that one from Stadler in the 42nd minute resulted in a goal. Villanova was very good about turning defense into offense in the first half as they had a couple of different opportunities to push the ball on net.
Yeah, that Stadler goal was unassisted. It was a breakaway for the Villanova Wildcats, and Butler goalie just couldn't stop her.
Yeah, Stephanie Rodriguez was actually quite a bit of the way outside the goalie box and made one save before the ball ended up getting past her. Good play from Butler in the first half. We'll see what they can put together here in half number two.
Yeah, the Bulldogs had 64% of the possession, so definitely the majority in that first half. They're going to want to try and remain with that possession total, or even increase it if they could.
And a break forward now for Macy Miller, but looks like they're going to call that offsides. Miller, the senior transfer from Indiana, showed a lot of good speed in the first half, put together a couple of offensive shifts. And it looks like back on the field for the second half. Of course, you have Anya Savage, Macy Miller, Celia Gaynor, Morgan Klusterman, Katie Soderstrom, who's by the ball there, as she defends on the far side of the field. A lot of contact there. They'll call it off on the Wildcats. Quick throw in. Collected by Leonard now. Nice piece of footwork there. Place it back and forward. Tries to get to Soderstrom. Too much pressure there. And Villanova will play it back ahead. Alyssa Yarish with it now. Taylor Crow tries the touch to collect the pass from Yarish, but she misses on it. And that'll be out for a Villanova throw-in. Seven different Butler players in the first half played the full 45 minutes. Compare that to four for the Wildcats. Maybe you talk about why Villanova was able to reverse the field so quickly, because they had fresh legs on. Soderstrom with it now. To her right to Leonard. Deflected off. And they play it back to Rodriguez now.
Butler's been known for their speed of their players. And I think in that first half, it was seen a little bit, but they can definitely capitalize it more in this half.
Good deflection from Peyton Black there as they try to cross into the middle. Julia Leonard with it now. Gives it out to Soderstrom, who's fouled. Yeah, not many fouls in the first half, only three total. Peyton Black for the Bulldogs collected two of them. And the free kick on the near side. Leonard elects to play it back instead. Gives it to Schmidt. Headed by the Villanova midfielder. Peyton Black with it now, center of the field. Dishes it out to her right. Soderstrom with it. On to Gaynor. Plays it back to, looks like that was Savic. Klusterman gets a touch. Tries to get it out to the left to Macy Miller. And Miller fouls number 11, Vince Segura. And Villanova will have it.
There's also only one offsides call in that first half, so girls on both sides of the team have been doing a pretty good job of staying on sides.
Yeah, not exactly a routine first half where you see Butler get seven corner kicks. Only three fouls were committed. Butler had 64% of the possession. And you see them trailing 1-0 at halftime. A lot of really interesting factors playing into the game so far here this afternoon. Again, if you're just joining us at a halftime, it's 1-0. Villanova. In about the 50th minute of play. Villanova pops it up. Played down on the ground toward the middle to Yarish. Out to the left to Crow. And Yarish plays it back to Rodriguez.
And you'll notice the way this Butler team is able to maintain that possession is through the passing. They pass a lot back to the goalie and in their defensive side of the half.
Gaynor gets it in the center of the field now. Divvies it out. Leonard, who's making a run. And deflected out by Villanova. So Butler will still have it. Soderstrom's going to take the throw in. Finds Klusterman. Klusterman with a touch to Soderstrom, who's coming out of her throw in. But she couldn't corral it. And that goes out for a Villanova goal kick now. Soderstrom was one of those eight Bulldogs who played all 45 minutes in the first half. Doesn't have a goal to show for it, but she was really putting pressure on the Villanova defense. Olcott with it now for Villanova. And she's fouled. So Villanova will take it near side of the field. Stoppage of play here. Referee explaining. Kristen Barber for the Wildcats takes the free kick. It's a long ball trying to find McIntyre. Butler gets the header on the ground now and puts it back out to Leonard. Soderstrom. Andrika Smith gives it on to Alyssa Yarish. Taylor Crow finds Peyton Black. And Butler now is finding it a little more difficult to get in as deep on offense as they were finding in the first half. A good ball finds Soderstrom. She's got a little bit of room on the right side, looking for a cross somewhere. She leads the team in assists, and she loses it. Villanova now trying to push it upfield. And Soderstrom then commits a foul. And that looks like it's going to be a yellow card for Soderstrom. Just a little bit frustrated that she couldn't find the angle to make the pass on toward goal.
First yellow card of this game as well.
Again, Soderstrom is a 5'5 sophomore from Carmel, Indiana, and she's already showing what kind of contribution she lends to this team.
Yeah, she's been a key component to the Butler team throughout this entire year and last year. She's taken majority of those corner kicks and close throw-ins to create those offensive opportunities for the Bulldogs.
And like we mentioned up front, as another hard foul there, this time by Klusterman. And Villanova will have a free kick. Soderstrom again leads the team in assists so far this season. She's got seven of them. And Soderstrom scored the only goal in the matchup versus DePaul. A flick on goal toward Stephanie Rodriguez. But Butler defends it well, just outside the goalie box. And this will be the second corner kick of the game for Villanova. Kristen Barber will take it, one of the team captains.
You'll see Villanova leads three defenders still back in the middle of the field just in case that ball comes out.
Plays it on the ground toward one of those three defenders, tries to put it on goal, can't find anyone. Chloe O'Neill with it now, looking for space again, blocked up by Annika Schmidt. But no one back to collect it for the Bulldogs. Kristen Vinciguerra now And deflected out by Leonard. Throw in. Villanova with it now. Looking for a cross. Easily handled as it bounces on goal toward Rodriguez. Katie Soderstrom with it. Now Anya Savage. Back to Soderstrom. Tries to flick it on toward Klusterman. Didn't get the touch she wanted. And Villanova will play it back to Gartner. Gartner pops it up. Header won by Villanova, but Peyton Black collects it for the Bulldogs now. A lot more of Butler's offensive possessions coming on their own half of the field. You compare that to only 43% of their possession in the first half was on their own defensive side. And it looks like another foul committed by Butler. So now play getting a little more physical, a little more frustrated that the number of opportunities they've had haven't translated to goals like Butler's normally used to.
Yeah, play is definitely getting more physical in the second half. I'd say we've seen already the amount of fouls that we saw in the first half just in the...
Macy Miller trying to press on Vince Segura. And she takes it all the way across the field now. Back to Kristen Barber. Barber with space. Trying to find Olcott. A lot of contact there, but Butler does win the ball back. Out to the far side. Savage with it. And gives it off to Taylor Crow, who's right there to assist. Hounded by Olcott. Crow will throw it in, but not before two substitutions. Morgan Klusterman will go out, as will Anya Savage for a quick breather. And in will come number nine, Becky Dean. And number 16, Gretchen Skoglund. Throw in by Crow, put out by Olcott.
Both girls that just came in are also freshmen, again, focusing on that young Butler team and those fresh legs coming in.
Butler playing the defense more tightly in the midfield rather than on Villanova's side of the field. Olcott with it. Sam Rosett now looking for Bryce McIntyre. And Butler has to play it out. So it'll be the third corner kick of the match now. Once again, it's 1-0. Villanova leads the Bulldogs in the 14th minute of play.
Nikki Molina for 20, Allison Breed.
Nikki Molina will come back in. We saw her for 18 minutes in the first half. Played well, got a couple of touches. And Villanova take the corner. It's inside the 18-yard box, but they can't head it on goal.
The Butler defense has been doing a good job protecting that goal box right there and not letting that ball get any further.
And now they're starting to get in a little more defensive rhythm because they're playing defense more often. In the first half, they largely relied on their offensive skills getting on Villanova's side of midfield. Rodriguez will take it back, gives it back out to Annika Schmidt. Schmidt plays it ahead, intercepted by Chloe O'Neill, fouled. Lot more physical fouls here. Looks like that one was committed by number nine, Becky Dean, just into the game. One of the freshmen that Sydney was talking about. Five, 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 keep wondering who's going to be the Butler playmaker in this game. Who is going to finally help them break through? Who's going to make that play that ties it up? Long ball by Barber, almost into the goalie box. Defended well. Skoglund with it. Trying to run. Out to her left. Macy Miller. She has a little bit of space. Hounded by Connor Huggins. She, again, takes it off to the left. Goes all the way down the field now. Good possession there. Trying to get the ball back. But Villanova takes it. Good defensive pressure toward the goal. And they make Villanova play it out on their own side of midfield.
Macy Miller showing that Butler speed that we were talking about earlier.
Becky Dean with it now. Can't find Miller. Peyton Black gives it off to Annika Schmidt. Julia Leonard back to Schmidt. Toward one of the three Butler forwards. Gaynor with it now. Gives it back off to Leonard. Soderstrom on the edge of the field. Leonard. Miscommunication there. Couldn't find Skoglund. Butler again plays it out. Quick throw in. Trying to get to Skoglund. No foul call. A lot of contact. Flying bodies. Bryce McEnroy making a run now. Ball popped up on the back of Annika Schmidt there as she defensed McEnroy. And Peyton Black will take it now. Villanova pressing much harder than they were in the first half. Taylor Crow puts it on the ground. Back to Peyton Black. And Alyssa Yarish gets a touch.
I think as this game goes on, each team gets a little more tense, waiting to see if any goals are going to go in.
Becky Dean. There was no offside flag. At the 18-yard box, a good save made by Rebecca Gartner on a shot from Macy Miller. It was a very good run by Becky Dean. Just couldn't find the good scoring opportunity. Olcott for Villanova. Two more substitutions for Villanova now.
14 Shannon Casey for 7 Sam Rosette. Also on for Villanova, 29 Shea Seyfart for 13 Daniela Nelson.
We're in the 63rd minute of play here, second half, Butler University playing Villanova. The first home match of the season for the Bulldogs in the Big East. Fifth home game so far this season. And Skoglund with the foul. Or no, Skoglund is fouled, and Butler will take the free kick. Yarish. Reverses the side of the field to Leonard, to Gaynor, puts it on to Soderstrom, who had that yellow card earlier in the second half. Soderstrom looks to throw it in. Puts it up to Leonard. Gaynor heads it, tries to gain control, gets it now. Soderstrom tries to play it through to Macy Miller. But the Villanova defense puts it out again. So Soderstrom now from about the 20-yard line. Finds Leonard, who puts it up in the air looking for someone to corral it. And it goes out yet again. About to enter the 65th minute here. A lot of hard contact there.
Into the match for Villanova, 21 Michaela Stadler, 4-9 Bryce McEnroy.
Looks like there's a Bulldog injured on the far side of the field. Can't see exactly who it is. They made hard contact with Chloe O'Neill. Just on the edge between, looks like that's Soderstrom. Yeah, Soderstrom and O'Neill collided right on the edge between the artificial turf and some rocks. And she's getting a little bit of medical attention. But it seems she'll stay in the game.
Yeah, these girls are just putting their bodies on the line in the second half of that game to try and tie it up for Butler.
And Butler takes it now. Soderstrom. She'll give it off to Annika Schmidt, who will throw it in. She's going to wipe off the ball with a towel. It was raining here a lot before the start of the game today. It cleared up right about when the game started. Schmidt tries to play it in, but it misses everyone. And Butler ends up playing it out, so it'll be a goal kick for Villanova. Villanova 1-1 in Big East play so far this season, just like the Bulldogs are. Every win crucial here because the Bulldogs want to get into the Big East tournament.
The Big East women's soccer is an extremely tough conference. Every game for the Big East is going to be a tough competition.
I mean, you mentioned Villanova played Georgetown before this game. Every game is going to be a difficult one from this point out.
Yeah, that Georgetown team ranked number 11th nationally, so definitely a tough competition.
Alyssa Yarish. To number 19, Carly Gehring. Now fresh in the game. And Villanova plays it out. Butler throw in. Still 1-0. Butler looking for the equalizer. 62nd minute of play now. Gehring throws it back to Rodriguez. Rodriguez plays it out to her right to Annika Schmidt. Schmidt looking down the field. Finds Soderstrom, but Soderstrom plays it out on her body. O'Neill takes the throw for Villanova. Soderstrom gets it back. And Macy Miller with it now. Good energy from Miller here in the second half.
I think that was smart of the coaches to give Miller that little break on the bench so she can come in with these fresh legs now for the second half.
Between Miller and Soderstrom, they've put up a lot of the offensive push in this game to this point. You also talk about Anya Savic. We haven't seen a ton from her. She's on the bench right now, but she is the team's leading scorer and shot taker. You expect when Butler gets the opportunity, she'll come back in the game. Gretchen Skoglund out to the left, looking for a cross inside. Plays it out. Kristen Barber played it out on the touchline for the Wildcats. So Butler will now have its eighth corner of the game.
First corner of this half for the Bulldogs, too. So we'll see if their strategy has changed at all since the first.
Soderstrom will take it again. By the near post, goalie punches it out. Collected by Olcott. And Butler will still have possession in their offensive zone. Carly Gehring will take it. He'll take a couple steps back as they want to really get the ball on goal here. Stoppage of play. 64th minute of play. Butler still trails 1-0. Carly Gehring, fresh legs, plays it a little too far ahead. But Villanova defenses it out. They'll have a throw in again.
Gehring was able to fake the Villanova defense out a little bit during that throw in and actually threw it back to one of the defenders to play back in the box.
Gehring, a 5'8 senior from Wayzata, Minnesota. And Villanova plays it out again. Good offensive presence on this shift by the Bulldogs. And unlike earlier in the game, now Butler opting to put two midfielders or two defensemen back to maybe prevent against the run we saw earlier, which led to the Michaela Stadler goal. They keep possession here, but Connor Huggins takes it now for Villanova. She's running up the left-hand side. Tries to play it ahead, and it goes out of bounds. 20 minutes to play here in this one. It's the 70th minute. Butler still trailing 1-0.
So we're a little more than halfway done with the second half, so here's where we'll see the game just get a little bit more chippy.
Again, Butler's only been shut out once so far this season, and that was an overtime tie against Utah. As they really need someone to step up. The throw in comes back to Villanova now, and Villanova's going to look to run. Along the right-hand side, and they've got space. A good save by Rodriguez. Nearly a far back post touch by Villanova. That could have been dangerous. A little more on goal there, and Villanova's up 2-0 instead of 1.
It was a very close Villanova touch on the far side of the goal.
Substitution for Villanova, number 4, Sierra Terrabasso, for 8, Jane Olcott.
Sierra Terrabasso in now for Jane Olcott. As Macy Miller has it now, Bulldogs of reverse field. Close in. There was a lot of contact on that slide by the Villanova defender. Very nearly in the 8-yard box.
Butler team and fans obviously disappointed in that call. Wanted a PK out of that.
Again, you talk about it's been chippy much of the second half, but maybe that, maybe from the Butler point of view, that was a little too much contact. Meanwhile, Soderstrom with it now. Tries to play it in, tries to flick on. Becky Dean with it, plays across. Macy Miller has it again. And Villanova plays it out, still in Butler's possession though. So no PK, no foul, but Butler still has a chance to get something out of this trip down in the offensive zone. They're looking for the equalizer. 17 minutes left in this one.
Butler putting a lot of pressure right now offensively.
Long throw in, looking for Annika Schmidt. But it's deflected out of Villanova. So it's the 9th corner of the game for the Bulldogs now. You've got to take advantage of at least one of these opportunities. Soderstrom will take the corner again like she has all game. Carly Gehring back as the lone defender. The cross in. Up in the air. Gaynor touches it. Yaris tries to get it. Leonard gets a touch. And Rebecca Gartner collects it. Gartner pushes it. Down the field. Header won by Leonard. Collected back by Gaynor. And Butler's back on the offense now. Soderstrom. On the right-hand side, plays it ahead to Miller. Miller trying to beat Kristen Barber on the left-hand side. Crosses her now. looking for a room for a shot. Soderstrom with it. And Barber collects it, plays it back out toward midfield. Connor Huggins for Villanova, defended by number 6, Julia Leonard. Good defensive play there, but Butler gives it right back. And Butler needs to get back on defense. Annika Schmidt with a good slide. Deep into the zone go the Wildcats. Defended by Annika Schmidt, and Butler takes possession. Good defensive presence there. Soderstrom trying to get ahead on the field, but looking for numbers. Gives it off to Leonard. And Villanova will get it back. We've got 15 minutes left in this one as Skoglund gets it back now. Gives it on to Celia Gaynor. Tries to make a move inside, but passes to no one. Soderstrom was streaking toward the goal. Becky Dean now, trying to defend the Villanova midfielder. Annika Schmidt on defense. Good play there, but Butler plays it out on the side. A lot of tired legs right now. Going to get a couple of substitutions in on both sides here.
Substitutions for Villanova, 13, Daniela Nelson, for 29, Shea Safart. Also on 20, Allison Breed, for 16, Nikki Molina. Into the dog, 7, Anya Savage.
Anya Savage, leading scorer back in this game now. And a flick on toward goal, easily handled by Rodriguez.
Yeah, I think having Savage back in this game is a great coaching decision and really should help the Dogs turn this game around.
She probably got about 15 minutes worth of rest, which could make all the difference coming down the stretch. Skoglund with it now, looking to move on the left-hand side. Alyssa Yarish dishes it back to Rodriguez. And Butler trying to make an advance up the field. Yarish to Skoglund. Skoglund decides to go back. And they're going to play it all the way back. Skoglund finds Gaynor, but it was too far out of her reach. Becky Dean is going to be out now.
8, Jane Olcott, for 4, Sierra Terabeso.
Coming back in is Morgan Klusterman, number 8 for the Dogs.
14, Shannon Casey. And 9, Bryce McEnroy, for 21, Michaela Stadler.
Yeah, both teams getting back their starting lineups on the field now. Trying to put this game out of reach if you're Villanova and trying to get that equalizer you've needed for a long time. Macy Miller with the touch now. Skoglund saves it. Trying to play it back inside. Gets it to Annika Schmidt. Julia Leonard to Morgan Klusterman. Back to Leonard. Soderstrom with it. Room to run. And it was a 2-on-1 for Soderstrom. Didn't have room to maneuver it there. She'll get the chance to throw it in now. Into Savage. And deflected out on Butler. We've got 12 minutes left in this contest here. Villanova leads 1-0. Peyton Black gets it back on offense for the Dogs. Tries to get it to Miller, but there was no one in the center of the offensive zone. And they're going to call that a trip by Bryce McEnroy. Butler takes over on offense quickly. Klusterman puts it out right to Soderstrom. Saichi's been on all game, looking for the cross inside, deflected by Barber. Klusterman got a touch quickly. Trying to get it out are the Wildcats. They can't do so. Annika Schmidt comes in to take the throw in. Now.
Smart for Schmidt to take that throw in so you have all your offensive players up in the box.
Long throw in. Tries to find Savage. Can't do it. Deflected back out to Schmidt, who manages to keep possession. They're back across midfield as they put it out to Skoglund on the left. Hounded by Vince Agura. And they're going to call that a foul on Skoglund. She was double-teamed over there, looking for someone to help out. She just couldn't find anyone in time. Flick ahead by Barber. And it's going to be a throw-in.
For Villanova, 7, Sam Rosette.
Sam Rosette comes in now again. She's the graduate transfer from the University of Virginia. As McEnroy, not much space, she plays it out, and that'll be a goal kick for the Bulldogs. Still some time here. We're in the 81st minute. Butler trails 1-0. Butler had most of the offensive possession in the first half. They've struggled a little more to keep possession here in the second half, but play's been a lot more physical, and they've had a lot better quality of opportunities now. Olcott overplays Kara Josie, and a throw-in will be taken by Alyssa Yarish. Played out by Vince Agura. Back in now. Savage tries to play it across. Manages to get it ahead. Leonard to Soderstrom. Team leader in assists. Soderstrom to Klusterman. Looks to cross back post. And that was nearly a goal by number 15, Gaynor. She just put it over the crossbar. That was a really quality opportunity there by the Dogs. First one we've seen in a while.
Yeah, Gaynor barely missing that touch right over the crossbar.
Gaynor also a sophomore on this team. Stock full of sophomore standouts. Headed by Peyton Black back into the offensive zone. Skoglund manages to keep it. And on the sideline, Villanova will take the throw-in as it went off of Skoglund there. Villanova now just puts it out of bounds. Tries to get into Gaynor, does Yarish.
Villanova is definitely trying to use that wasting time tactic as there's about 7 minutes left in this game.
Again, Butler looking for one goal to even it up. And Savage there thought it went out on Villanova, opted not to touch the ball. Instead, it goes out on Savage, and Butler's back on defense again. Again, with 7 minutes now to play. We're in the 83rd minute. A foul there by McEnroy. Kicked the neck of the Butler defender. Leonard gets it to Klusterman, who gives it right back. Soderstrom plays it up the field now. Couple of Butler players in the vicinity. Skoglund trying to get towards center, maybe put a shot on goal. defense by Connor Huggins for the Wildcats. Klusterman now plays it ahead to Skoglund again. Macy Miller with it, loses it. And this is going to be difficult now as... Nope, Villanova doesn't manage to save it before it goes out of bounds. They had a couple of players going toward the touchline. Spacing just didn't work, though. Throws it over the head of everyone on that throw-in. But Villanova played out again. 5 minutes now. 5.5 minutes into Gaynor. Gaynor tries to get to Savage. Goes a little past her reach, though. Here's the wasting time tactic Sydney was talking about as Villanova plays it all the way back.
Yeah, Villanova isn't forcing too much offense on the Bulldogs, but they're really protecting their own goal and all over the Bulldogs on this defensive side.
Yeah, at the end of a physical game like this, you want to make your opponent run as much as possible, make them use up all their energy to get that equalizer. McEnroy plays it off again. And Gaynor gets the toss off the throw in. Ahead to Schmidt, who plays it to Soderstrom. Butler trying to space out now. Good pass through the legs. Klusterman gets it. Ahead to Savage, but couldn't get the touch to get it to Macy Miller. No foul there. Peyton Black now gives it to Alyssa Yarish. Just on the other side of midfield. Plays it ahead now. Gaynor tries to flick it on to Klusterman. And that's going to be a foul. Foul committed.
Penalty kick for the Dogs here.
Foul committed inside the 18-yard box. It was Soderstrom, who's been active all game, manages to just... draw enough contact.
Yeah, this is exactly the opportunity the Bulldogs needed right now, a free penalty kick to try and even it up.
If you're wondering, it's going to be Anya Savage, the team's leading scorer, to take the penalty kick. Butler's had only one penalty kick so far this season. Savage took it. She scored. This time, she gets it! And that's the equalizer.
Anya Savage tying it up with 4 minutes left in this game.
In the 85th minute, the Dogs never said die, and they finally get that equalizer that they've been waiting for all game. Well executed there. Crowd very happy to see something come of all those efforts by the Bulldogs here in this game.
Yeah, in a home game here a couple weeks ago, that same situation happened where there was a penalty kick and Anya Savage took it and scored it again. It's tied up.
But now the Dogs have to play defense. Attempted cross here. Dangerous bounce back into the center of the field. McEnroy gets it. The shot by number 13, Daniela Nelson, far above the goal. So Rodriguez will take it on the goal kick. We're tied at one here. Goal in the 85th minute on the penalty kick by Anya Savage. Ties it up. And a foul by Villanova. Butler will take the free kick. 3 minutes, 20 seconds left now. Annika Schmidt plays it ahead to Peyton Black. Tries to find Skoglund. Instead, Vince Segura will take it. Vince Segura on the right-hand side to Michaela Stadler. The lone Wildcat with a goal in this game. Annika Schmidt plays it back to Rodriguez. Rodriguez gets it out to Skoglund. And played out by Michaela Stadler, but we'll get the throw in.
both teams going all out right now for the last 2.5 minutes of this game, just trying to avoid the ball being on their side of the goal.
Imagine the moral victory for Butler if they're able to somehow get a second goal in these last 5 minutes of the game. As that's stolen now, Soderstrom looking up ahead, seeing who's going to make a run, plays it instead to the left to Skoglund. Out by midfield, Soderstrom now. She's switched positions with Savage. Alyssa Yarish plays it back to Stephanie Rodriguez, who's made a couple of really nice saves so far in this game. Annika Schmidt looks for a streaking. Was looking for Celia Gaynor, couldn't get it there. Now Klusterman has it on the left-hand side, and not a great angle on the shot. But again, more offensive pressure put on by the Dogs. And we're in the 89th minute here. As Rebecca Gartner, who made three nice saves in the first half, gives the goal kick. Vin Segura nearly gets it ahead. She does now to Jane Olcott. Olcott looking to push to Michaela Stadler. Played out by Peyton Black. Villanova will have a throw-in with 1 minute to play. Vin Segura.
1 minute. 1 minute to
down
play.
To Stadler. Hounded by Black. Butler wins it now. Gretchen Skoglund. Celia Gaynor has it. Soderstrom in the center of the field. Plays it out to her right. Julia Leonard. Leonard ahead to Miller. Can she get the touch? And the touch by Skoglund. Again, a goal saved in the 89th minute here. 25 seconds left here in this one. Butler and Villanova are tied at one. Skoglund ahead to Gaynor. She loses it. Gaynor nearly gets it back. Connor Huggins now. Less than 10 seconds. Michaela Stadler. And it looks like the Dogs are going to overtime here in this one. A great chance where they fought all the way back. As they played most of the second half down that one goal, they finally get it back in the 85th minute of play on a penalty kick by Anya Savage, who's now 2 for 2 in penalty kicks this season.
Yeah, you know, during that half and as the game as a whole, I think that Butler proved to be the better team. They had possession a lot more of the time than Villanova did. And there were so many shots that were just so close to going in, like that Celia Gaynor missed header right over the crossbar, and then obviously that Skoglund shot that was just saved just a minute ago. So I think if they can, in overtime, get one of those shots in, they're going to be really successful today.
Sydney, who would you say the momentum favors right now? You talk about Villanova led most of this game. Butler gets it back, but both teams are still fighting after a physical second half of play. What are they looking to do here in overtime?
Yeah, you know, I think Butler does have the momentum going into this overtime period. They had those really close opportunities, and during the last 15 minutes of play, they battered that Villanova goal continuously with shots, and Villanova just wasn't really trying to get that shot. They were trying to stop the equalizer. So right now, if they come out just as they were in this last 15-20 minutes of that game, I think Butler should have the momentum.
I mean, we talk about Savage, leading scorer on this team, getting the penalty kick goal, but so many other players on this team have had a profound effect on this game. Katie Soderstrom, the sophomore, leading assist on the team. She was very active in both halves of this game. Had a minor injury there, got back up, helped facilitate on that goal. She drew the penalty inside the goalie box there. And Macy Miller, the senior transfer from Indiana University, very active in the second half as well. Showed a lot of good energy.
Yeah, Soderstrom and Miller both were vital to Butler play, especially in that second half. I think both of them having that time off to rest their legs, just even for 10, 15 minutes that they got, was really helpful to allow them to come back in and make a difference in that second half.
Yeah, and you absolutely talked about the contributions of some people like Carly Gehring and Aaliyah Dean and everyone else who allowed Butler's best players on the team to get those couple minutes of rest, which helped them down the stretch.
Yeah, those freshmen like Becky Dean and Gretchen Scoglin, they were able to come in and give those girls rest, but also like produce offensive opportunities that Butler really needed in that second half to gain momentum.
Yeah, Scoglin was very active in the second half. She really had a profound effect on moving the ball down the field. She was on the opposite side of Soderstrom. And they help push the ball forward. And if you get the ball in the goalie box, good things will often happen.
Yeah, and the persistence shown by Butler just in that last 20 minutes of the second half was really important. They just never gave up and kept trying and ended up getting that equalizer to go into this overtime period.
And those 9 corner kicks so far in this contest really caught up to Villanova. By the end, they just allowed Butler so many opportunities to put the ball in the back of the net. They played really good defense the rest of the game, but one opportunity too many, it would appear, leads to the Dogs being tied here going into overtime with the Wildcats tied at 1.
Yeah, Butler has 11 shots right now compared to the Villanova 7, so a lot of those came in that last period of the second half, so that should help them going into this overtime.
Yeah, Butler had 5 shots in the first half, 6 in the second. The 6 in the second obviously came with a lot more urgency as they needed every last one of those to tie up the score.
Stephanie Rodriguez, the Butler goalie, was also needed a lot more in that second half, especially in the beginning when Villanova was getting a lot of shots on net. So she really helped the Bulldogs out to keep the 1-0 lead instead of the 2-0.
We haven't even mentioned the good save by Rodriguez earlier in the second half. It was an opportunity where Villanova nearly put the ball in the back of the net. Rodriguez had saved it once, and the Villanova forward just couldn't put it in the back of the net. Without that save by Rodriguez, we're looking at a completely different situation here.
Yeah, and as we mentioned, every Big East win is important. I mean, these teams are tough, so the record is important, and Butler really wants a win today.
Scoglin will stay in the game as well. Macy Miller, Anya Savage, Katie Soderstrom, Celia Gaynor, Morgan Klusman, Annika Schmidt, Julia Leonard, Alyssa Yarish, and Amanda Kowalski now comes in the game. Saw her in the first half. Kowalski with the touch now on the right-hand side. Gives it off to Miller. Back to Kowalski. Miller will get it before it gets out of the touch line, but overshoots everyone. Villanova corrals it.
Yeah, the teams have also switched sides for this overtime period, so the Dogs are now trying to score on that same goal they were during the first half.
Butler elects to play it back to Rodriguez. You want to be really careful about your possession in an overtime period here. You really can't afford to give it up. You can't afford the change of possession that Butler had in the first half, where they just couldn't corral the ball as it was going back toward their own goal, and that ended up leading to that Villanova goal by Michaela Stadler. Foul committed there by Bryce McEnroy for Villanova, so Butler will get it back. Puts it out to the center of the field now. Annika Schmidt looks to direct. Intercepted by Connor Huggins. Huggins plays it forward, but that's out of everyone's reach. Sam Rosick couldn't get it. Bryce McEnroy was also moving toward the Butler goal, but they weren't anywhere near where they were able to get a touch on that ball.
Yeah, Butler's passes have been intercepted a lot lately, so I think that's something they need to be a little bit more cautious of going into this overtime.
Yeah, Butler was having a lot of success with ground passes in the first half. We saw a little more use of heading in the second half, but overall, they definitely have to get their ground game. It's out on Villanova, so Skoglund will take the throw in. Puts it forward to Savage. Savage back with it now. A hard shot. And Bryce McEnroy. She collects it now on the Butler side of the 50. Leonard and Yarish out trying to defend. And Villanova couldn't get it before it got to the touchline. And Rodriguez will take it.
You can see in that play, Bryce McEnroy of the Villanova Wildcats was able to speed her way down the field. She's one of those girls that was able to get about like 10, 15 minutes of rest to have those fresh legs going into overtime.
Rodriguez with the goal kick. It gets back now to number 16, Nikki Molina, for the Wildcats. There's 6.5 minutes left in the first overtime period. There's a foul committed, they're going to say, by Celia Gaynor. Or no, Klusterman instead. And Kristen Barber, one of the captains of this Villanova team, will take it. And this is a big opportunity for Villanova here, if they can convert. The cross in, deflected out. Savage gets it. And they get it back closer to center of the field. Barber back with it. Nikki Molina now looking to make a move, trying to play it into McIntyre. Good run by McIntyre. Butler defended it well, though. 5 minutes, 40 seconds left in the first overtime period. And they're going to give a yellow card to the Villanova coach.
The official has presented a yellow card to the Villanova coaching staff.
You're going to see a lot more fouls throughout this overtime period as well. Just as the girls and the teams get more tired, more fouls are tend to be committed.
Yeah, that yellow card on Villanova coach Chris McLean. He's in his third year at Villanova. Not sure what the situation was there. Villanova wins the ball back. Gives it back to Kristen Barber. Barber plays it ahead. And Savage just doesn't give enough room to the Villanova midfielder to head that ball. So it's a foul. Villanova will get a free kick just on the other side of midfield.
Savage again was that one goal for Butler on the penalty kick.
Barber out to the left. Chloe O'Neill. Connor Huggins now. Works toward the goal. Gives it to Vince Agura. Fakes the shot from 20 yards out. Fakes it again. Nearly loses the ball. And now three Butler defenders converge on it. Gives it out to Savage. Savage trying to get it ahead to Macy Miller. A little out of her reach. Barber will play it back. Savage gets it. Savage running again. And foul is going to be called. Looks like that's on Sam Rosett. Yeah, Savage laboring a little bit. She's been a little more active here in overtime. Committed a foul a couple minutes ago. was fouled there.
Savage is an extremely powerful forward for the Butler team, and as we said, she does lead the team in goals scored, so she's trying to add another one today.
Savage, 5'10", one of the taller players on this team. A cross in by Amanda Kowalski. Look toward the back post. They miss Savage. They nearly got Annika Schmidt involved there, but it ended up going out. A little over 3 minutes here left in the first overtime period. And a sub back in for Villanova. Shea Safard in back now. Gartner, goalie for Villanova, kicks it out. After a couple bounces, collected by Skoglund. Played out by Villanova. Klusterman puts it up in the air. Now Skoglund has it. Working back toward midfield. Puts it back to Kowalski. Amanda Kowalski with that good cross on that free kick opportunity moments ago. Leonard. Back to Alyssa Yarish. And Villanova opting to defend instead of trying to press on the ball as fiercely as they were in most of the second half. Played all the way across the field. Leonard. Skoglund loses it. Ball stays in play. Back to Annika Schmidt. Less than 2 minutes left now in overtime. Michaela Stadler with it, the goal scorer for Villanova in this game. Plays it back to Kristen Vinciguerra, who puts it ahead to Jane Olcott. She plays it out of bounds.
Yeah, both teams do seem to be in a bit of a hurry in this overtime. Neither of them want a tie in their Big East record. They both want to have a win today.
And Alyssa Yarish now in need of medical attention. Looks like a cramp, perhaps.
Yeah, 90 minutes is already exhausting for these girls, so to add these extra overtime periods oftentimes results in injuries such as cramps like this.
And Yarish is going to go out here.
Shannon Casey for 9, Bryce McEnroy.
Coming in for Yarish is Peyton Black, who had been replaced by Amanda Kowalski here in overtime. Gaynor puts it back in play. Villanova wins it back.
Peyton Black has 2 fouls. She did play the entire first half of this game.
Throw in for Villanova. Gotten by Leonard. Puts it back out. We've got 1 minute left here in the first overtime period.
1 minute to play.
Throw in from Villanova. Headed away by Peyton Black. Jane Olcott with it now for Villanova. Trying to find Michaela Stadler. Leonard lets it go out, and it's going to be a goal kick for the Dogs. A win today would be really big for Butler's confidence going forward. They didn't put on the best performance at DePaul, but a win against Villanova here would mean a lot. Peyton Black, and played out by Villanova. Butler will have a throw in.
10, 9,
with
10 8,
seconds here in the first
7,
overtime period.
6, 5, 4, 3,
Butler,
2,
and
1.
The Wildcats are still tied at 1 goal apiece. So we'll have 1 more period to see if a winner can emerge.
both teams getting a bit tired in that overtime half. There wasn't too many shots on goal for each team. So I think in this second half, they're really going to try and attempt those shots more to create the win.
We're headed to the second and final.
We talk about Alyssa Yarish going out on injury a couple of minutes ago. She was just on the training table. She's off now. We might see her in the second overtime here. But I'll put you in the coach's shoes, Sydney. What is your ace in the hole here in the second overtime? What's the thing that you absolutely need to see from your team? What's going to help you win here in the second overtime?
Yeah, you know, I think they need to focus on their offense and create an opportunity. I think if they do that, it'll fall into place. Overtime periods are short amounts of time. It's not going to be this whole long game like they had earlier where they can focus on defense and offense. I think they really need to push their offense and work for those corners and those free kicks because they are really great with set pieces, and I think if they showcase that, they'll be able to score another one and get this win today.
It's been an exciting game all through today, and it comes down to the second overtime period here. Butler and Villanova will switch sides again.
Yeah, for their Big East records, having a tie isn't going to give them as many points as a win will. And those points definitely matter going into their conference tournament and so on with the NCAA. So they really need a win today to count those points up.
Yeah, in that same vein, though, you will definitely always take a tie over a loss. You don't want to overcommit yourself and maybe give up the easy goal here in the waning minutes of overtime. So we'll see what the Dawgs' strategy is here. It looks like they'll opt to keep in Amanda Kowalski and Peyton Black. Again, Alyssa Yarish out with injury a couple minutes ago. She'll stay on the sidelines. We've got one final 10-minute overtime period here. It's tied at one.
Both teams are going to have those defenders focusing on not letting any balls go in that net because the loss in overtime is absolutely devastating. So I'm going to try and avoid that, definitely, both sides.
For the Dawgs, it's Skoglund, Savage, Macy Miller, Katie Soderstrom. She was very quiet in the first overtime period. Celia Gaynor. You got Peyton Black, Annika Schmidt, Amanda Kowalski, who takes the ball there. And she'll play it back to Stephanie Rodriguez, the goalkeeper. Morgan Klusterman. And Julia Leonard. Touch from Michaela Stadler. Played out by Amanda Kowalski. On the opposite side of the 50. Ball popped up. Peyton Black tries to get it to Soderstrom. Unable to. And the throw-in will be taken by number 14, Shannon Casey, for the Wildcats. She's a senior from Shelby Township, Michigan. Goes into Olcott. Played out by Butler. Throw-in by Vince Segura. Taken by Skoglund as she looks for room to run. Now they find Soderstrom. Soderstrom with a lot of room, looking ahead to Macy Miller, and right there to Amanda Kowalski. Kowalski wins it back. Back to Peyton Black now. Peyton Black puts it to the left side of the field, and Julia Leonard. Leonard puts it forward to Skoglund, but played out by Skoglund. Looked like it could have gone off Vince Segura there. But Villanova will take the throw in.
Soderstrom going for a run over there on the side. And I think if they get Soderstrom and Savage back in this game together, that's going to really help them. If they can match up, they're pretty much unstoppable, those two together.
Out of bounds by Villanova, trying to advance their offensive position. Only 10-minute period, 2 minutes of it already gone here in the second overtime. Gaynor misses on the header. Vince Segura can't control it either, though. Savage now puts it ahead to Miller. A little too far from Miller. Miller trying to get a touch on the ball. Kristen Barber now for Villanova. Puts it back. And Villanova with possession. Right about at midfield. Daniela Nelson. Morgan Klusterman. Celia Gaynor collects it. Won by Jane Olcott for the Wildcats. And a run made by Michaela Stadler. And the cross in just missed by number 7, Sam Rosett.
Stadler trying to assist on that goal as she had the one goal for Villanova earlier in that first half.
Stadler very involved on all the scoring opportunities for Villanova here. Shannon Casey back in the game. Savage wins the header. Kowalski with the height advantage gets it to Soderstrom. Soderstrom. Too hard for Macy Miller. 6.5 minutes left now. Dogs and Wildcats still tied at 1.
Bryce McEnroy for 7, Sam Rosett.
Bryce McEnroy comes back in the game. Sam Rosett comes out. Peyton Black with the ball now. Butler has possession. Good flick on by Peyton Black. Katie Soderstrom looking to run, looking to cross. Ball into the box, bit easily handled by Rebecca Gartner. Plays it back out to Vince Agura. Stolen by Soderstrom. Gives it off to Gaynor. Behind Soderstrom, who's making a run toward the goal. And Villanova now looking to push the pace. Olcott with it. Reagan Smith hands it off to Connor Huggins. Huggins feeding it across to Bryce McEnroe. Amanda Kowalski manages to get it out of the possession of McEnroe.
Definitely a sense of urgency on both sides, and we'll see it increase throughout the last 5 minutes of this game.
And that's recorded as the 10th shot for Villanova now. It's 11-10 in favor of shots on Butler's side.
Yeah, so as we see, Butler hasn't really had a shot since the end of that regular time.
Flick on by Savage. She collects it now and runs upfield. Trying to find Soderstrom. And Soderstrom collects it. Needs to finagle out of the tight coverage there. Nearly does so. Oh, but defended well by Chloe O'Neill. Hands it off to Michaela Stadler. Stadler looking to push the pace now. 4:30 left in overtime, the second overtime period. Stadler. They're going to call that out on Butler, which leads to a Villanova corner.
Butler defensive players not happy about that. They thought that should have been a goal kick and that it was out on the Villanova Wildcats.
There have been a couple of disagreements between the Butler camp and the referees here in the second half, but none of them have really put Butler at the ultimate disadvantage. Here, Kristen Barber will take the corner with 4 minutes left in the second overtime period. She plays it off to Connor Huggins from 20 yards out. Hits the crossbar. It's bouncing around in there, and they're going to call a foul. That was very, very close. Rodriguez had it defensed well. Still hit the crossbar for Villanova.
Yeah, pretty lucky that that ball hit the crossbar, but nice to know that your goalie was right under it if it didn't.
Butler looking to play it ahead, but Miller the only one back there. Barber pops it up, wins the ball back. Bryce McEnroy to Connor Huggins now. Daniela Nelson to Reagan Smith. Connor Huggins, the one who hit the crossbar a moment ago, to Bryce McEnroy. Across the face of the goal, but no one there for Villanova. 2.5 minutes left for the Bulldogs. Macy Miller rushing to try and get a touch on it. Played out. Butler will have a throw in. 2 minutes, 25 seconds left in the second overtime period. There are no penalty kicks. A tie here if no goal is scored. Julia Leonard. Ball played out by Villanova.
Yeah, Butler really needs some offensive opportunities right here. Villanova's had the last few throughout this second overtime.
Julia Leonard will take the throw in on the near side of the field. Puts it in to Macy Miller. Gets the touch on the ball she'd been looking for so far in overtime. But she loses it. Reagan Smith behind McEnroy. Barber with it. Plays it ahead. Savage gets a touch on it. Julia Leonard now. Connor Huggins with the ball again. Peyton Black intercepts the pass. Plays it back to Amanda Schmidt, who plays it on the left-hand side to Gretchen Skoglund. Puts it into Gaynor, who gives it back out to Leonard. Peyton Black now on the offensive side of the 50. Amanda Kowalski puts it into Macy Miller. Can't win that ball either. Both teams fighting for it. Amanda Kowalski with the ball now. 1 minute left to play. Amanda Kowalski with the cross. And on the goalie. Rebecca Gartner collects it. Vince Agura. Butler needs to get back on defense. Vince Agura looking to push the pace. Reagan Smith. Smith. Dribbling it. Skoglund with 33 seconds left. They need to push it onto the offensive side. But there's no one there. And Chloe O'Neill puts it back for the Wildcats. And foul called against Butler. 19 seconds left. Stoppage of play.
Both teams going to give absolutely everything they have right now in these last few seconds of this game.
Well, at this point, I'm not sure if Butler has time to make it all the way and score another goal and win this game, but they need to play well on defense here and at least force the tie. Barber will take the free kick. They're going to send everyone to the edge of the 18-yard box, maybe hoping for a flick or a header in. They play it short instead. Barber has it back now. Tori Alfaro with it.
10 seconds left. Eight,
looking for a touch.
Six, five,
it's bouncing around.
Four, three,
Chloe O'Neill with it, and Kowalski
one.
Clears it, and it looks like that's going to be all here from the Selick Bowl. So after 110 minutes, Butler and the Villanova Wildcats come out tied at one. What did you think of the game, Sydney?
Yeah, you know, I thought these teams were really well matched. They played a tough game on both sides, offensive and defensively, both teams did. And, you know, I thought that Butler did maintain possession most of the game, but in these overtime periods, Villanova came back and did show a lot of pressure on the Bulldogs. So, Butler did have 12 shots, and Villanova had 11, so evenly matched there as well. Overall, it was a good game, and to come out with a tie instead of a loss for both these teams is good for both.
Yeah, tie against a quality opponent, even though it might not show up as perhaps as advantageous in the win column in Big East play, certainly lets your team know that they're on the right track, that they played a really good game, and that they have a lot of good opportunities coming for them later on in the season.
Yeah, I think this game will give them a lot to build off of for the next few games in Big East play.
We hope to see you back.
So again, Butler and the Villanova Wildcats finish here tied at 1. The Bulldogs will next travel to Nebraska to face the Blue Jays of Creighton this Thursday, October 10th. Kickoff at the 2019 Big East Championship site is set for 7 p.m. Eastern, or 7 p.m. Central, 8 p.m. Eastern. Butler will return home next on October 13th for a Sunday matchup against St. John's at the Selick Bowl for a 1 p.m. game. For all of us here at Butler Athletics, I'm David Clark. Thank you for listening to this presentation of Butler Women's Soccer.